Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to BANKERSADDA. Today is day 21 of Kar IBPS 2019 FATEH. Aaj ki quiz jo hai, wo data sufficiency pe based hai. Directions 1 to 5. Each of the questions below consist of a question and two statements numbered 1 and 2 given below it. You have to decide whether the data provided in the statement are sufficient to answer the questions. Read both the statements and give answers. Question number one. On which date Siddharth leaves for Jaunpur in January month? So, agar statement one dekhe. Siddharth leaves for 1 week from his office. Takes a leave for 1 week from his office in January month and starting from 15th of January. So, koi ek fixed nahi hai. Second, Siddharth's mother correctly remembers that Siddharth leaves for Jaunpur after 5th and but before 7th of January. So, clearly, statement second se hi hamara answer aa raha hai. Ki Siddharth jo hai. वो 6th of January को उसने leave किया है. Next question. Question number 2. इसलिए option B हमारा correct answer है. Question number 2. 5 persons A, B, C, D, E and are sitting around a circular table with all of them facing towards the center. Who sits immediate left of B? तो अगर statement 1 से देखें. A sits third to the right of B. 5 persons hain. So, agar B yahan hoga, to A hoga yahan. C sits third to the right of A. So, clearly C yahan hai. Bacche D aur A, unke beech mein confusion hai. To koi fix answer hume first statement se nahi aata hai. Statement 2 dekhe. B sits immediate left of C. B sits immediate left of C, who sits second to the left of A. So clearly A yahan hua. D does not sit adjacent to B. So clearly D yahan hua aur E yahan hua. So humse pucha gaya tha ki immediate left kaun hai B ke? So clearly E hai. Second statement se answer aa raha hai. Isliye option B hamara again correct answer hai. Question number 3. What is the code of called? First statement. In a certain language, meeting had been called is written as this. They called every time is written as this. So clearly first statement se hi hamara answer aa raha hai. Kyunki dono jo hume code diye gaye hain statement ke. Called hi common hai bas inme. That is BV. Isliye first statement se hamara answer aa raha hai. Second statement dekhte hain. You called every hour. To yahan se dekhen to kahi answer nahi aa raha hai. Isliye only from first statement hamara code aa raha hai. Called ka BV. इसलिए ऑप्शन ए हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. पॉइंट एस इज इन विच डायरेक्शन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू पॉइंट वाई. स्टेटमेंट 1. पॉइंट एस इज इन नॉर्थ ऑफ एक्स. तो क्लियरली अगर एक्स यहां कहीं है तो एस कहीं यहां होगा. पॉइंट एक्स इज इन ईस्ट ऑफ टी. तो क्लियरली कहीं टी यहां होगा. Point T is in north of V. So, kahin V is direction mein hoga. Which is west of Y. Now, Y yahan bhi ho sakta hai. Yahan bhi ho sakta hai. Yahan bhi ho sakta hai. So, alag alag places ho sakte hai. Aur inke based pe S ke respect mein bhi. Sorry, Y ke respect mein bhi S hamara alag alag direction mein hoga. Idhar alag direction mein hoga. Yahan se alag direction mein hoga. Aur yahan se alag direction mein hoga. So, statement 1 se answer nahi aa raha hai. Statement 2 dekhen. Y is in west of X. Y is in west of X. Point X is in west of T, which is north of V. V is east of S, which is south of X. So clearly S yahan hai. Aur V jo hai, wo east hai S ke. Clearly yahan se hum S ki direction bata sakte hain with respect to Y. That is southeast. इसलिए second statement से हमारा answer आ रहा है सिर्फ option B हमारा correct answer है. Question number 5 persons A, B, C, D are of different height. Who is heaviest? B is heavier than C and D. So statement 1 dekhe. B is heavier than C and D but lighter than E. Who is not the heaviest? So clearly ek person yaha hoga. 5 mein se, that is A hai yaha pe. So statement 1 se hume pata chal jata hai ki heaviest hamara A hai. Agar second statement pe jayen, E is heavier than B and C but lighter than A. So clearly A yaha pe hai. लेकिन डी की डी कौन सी पोजीशन पे ये स्पेसिफाइड नहीं है, इसलिए सिर्फ स्टेटमेंट 1 से ही हमारा आंसर आ रहा है, इसलिए ऑप्शन ए हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, डायरेक्शन 6 to 10. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, हु अमंगस्ट ए बी सी डी एंड ई इज द शॉर्टेस्ट. स्टेटमेंट 1 अगर देखें, ए इज टॉलर देन बी, ए इज टॉलर देन बी, ई इज नॉट द टॉलेस्ट. तो क्लियरली कुछ डेफिनेट आंसर नहीं आ रहा है. सेकेंड स्टेटमेंट देखें, सी इज टॉलर देन ए, सी इज टॉलर देन ए एंड डी इज नॉट द टॉलेस्ट. तो अगर हम दोनों को कंबाइन भी करते हैं, कंबाइनिंग बोथ, सी ग्रेटर देन ए ग्रेटर देन बी, ई इज नॉट द टॉलेस्ट, डी इज नॉट द टॉलेस्ट. तो क्लियरली हमें सी और डी ई के बीच में, क्लियरली ई और डी यहां तो नहीं होंगे. ई और डी अगर यहां हुए तब भी ई और डी की प्लेसमेंट हमें कंफर्म नहीं है. तो दोनों स्टेटमेंट्स कंबाइन करके भी हमारा आंसर नहीं आता है, इसलिए ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन 7, हाउ इज बी रिलेटेड टू ई. स्टेटमेंट 1, एम एंड जेड आर ब्रदर्स ऑफ बी, एम एंड जेड आर ब्रदर्स ऑफ बी, ई इज सन ऑफ जेड. स्टेटमेंट 2, डी इज मदर ऑफ यू, Who is son of B? दोनों स्टेटमेंट से इंडिविजुअली हमें आंसर नहीं आ रहा है, लेकिन अगर दोनों स्टेटमेंट्स को कंबाइन करते हैं तो हमारा जो ब्लड रिलेशन आएगा वो होगा कुछ ऐसे. तो यहां से B का जेंडर फिक्स हो रहा है और हमें क्लियरली पता चलता है कि B अंकल है E का, इसलिए कंबाइनिंग बोथ हमारा आंसर आ रहा है, इसलिए ऑप्शन E हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. Question 8. In which month of the year did Rinku go to Switzerland for a vacation? Statement 1 correctly remembers she went for vacation in the first half of the year. So clearly, January se June ke beech mein kahin Rinku gayi hai Switzerland. Second statement, Rinku's husband correctly remembers they went for a vacation after 31st of March and 1st May. So clearly, April mein gaye hai. इसलिए सिर्फ सेकंड स्टेटमेंट से हमारा आंसर है, इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9, इज पी मटर्नल आंट ऑफ एम. नोटिस करने की वाली बात है कि इज पूछा है तो आंसर या तो एस है, सॉरी यस है, या तो नो है. स्टेटमेंट 1, A is son of P, A is brother of B, B is daughter of C, F is sister of C, M is daughter of F. तो is P maternal aunt of M? यहां पे P और C का gender defined नहीं है, इसलिए यहां पे हम नहीं कर सकते answer. अगर सेकंड स्टेटमेंट में देखें, डी इज फादर ऑफ एम, एफ इज मदर ऑफ एम, के इज ब्रदर ऑफ एम, K has two children, J and R, and P is married to K. तो क्लियरली यहाँ पे P का जेंडर भी डिफाइंड हो रहा है और आंसर भी हमारा आ रहा है, इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. दैट इज सिर्फ सेकंड स्टेटमेंट से हमारा आंसर आ रहा है. क्वेश्चन 10. हु अमंग वी डब्ल्यू एक्स वाई जेड सिट्स इन द मिडल ऑफ द रो. सब साउथ देख रहे हैं. पहले स्टेटमेंट से देखते हैं. डब्ल्यू सिट्स सेकंड टू द राइट ऑफ वी. Z is not immediate neighbor of Y. तो हमें क्लियरली नहीं पता कि Z और Y कहाँ होंगे, कितने लोग किस डायरेक्शन में होंगे. हो सकता है कोई यहाँ हो, कोई यहाँ हो, कुछ नहीं पता है. तो फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट से हमारा आंसर नहीं आता है.
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम डिस्कस करेंगे डे 21 फॉर IBPS 2019 एग्जाम. आज का जो हमारा क्विज है दैट इज based on antonym and synonym. Antonym synonym in the sense vocabulary based है. ये जो pattern है ये नया तरीके का pattern है जो IBPS clerk mains में आया था, और ये new type के questions हैं जो clerk mains में आए थे इस साल. तो चलते हैं हमारे questions की तरफ. vocabulary बेस क्वेश्चंस हैं, आपको एंटोनिम सिनोनिम के फॉर्म में क्वेश्चंस दिए गए हैं. इजी हैं, बट यही है कि आपकी वोकैबुलरी टेस्ट की जाएगी. चलते हैं हमारे डायरेक्शंस की तरफ. डायरेक्शंस 1 to 5. इन द क्वेश्चंस गिवन बिलो 5 वर्ड्स आर गिवन इन विच 4 ऑफ देम हैव अ सिमिलर मीनिंग एंड 1 वर्ड इज द एंटोनिम फॉर द अदर 4 वर्ड्स. Choose the word opposite in meaning to the other 4 as your answer. Question number 1. तो आपको antonym select करना है. 5 words given है. इसमें से 4 words आपस में synonyms होंगे और 1 word उन 4 words का antonym होगा. मतलब 4 words का meaning same होगा और 1 word होगा उसमें से इन 5 words में से जिसका meaning उन 4 words के opposite होगा. तो फ्यूरी, फ्यूरी का मतलब एंगर. आयर का मतलब अगेन एंगर होता है. रेज अगेन एंगर, टेम्परामेंट, वायलेंट. एग्जास्पिरेशन अ फीलिंग ऑफ इंटेंस इरिटेशन और अनॉयंस टुवर्ड्स समथिंग और समवन. अगेन उसका मीनिंग एंगर ही हुआ. डिलाइट मतलब अच्छा फील करना, गुड फील करना. तो डिलाइट इसमें एंटोनिम हुआ इन चारों वर्ड्स का ऑपोजिट. तो इस क्वेश्चन का आंसर है ई. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. ओनस बेनिफिट ब्लेम चार्ज लोड. तो ओनस का अगर हम मतलब देखें तो इसका मतलब है किसी चीज का ब्लेम या क्रेडिट लोड, मतलब किसी चीज का कर्ज. तो ओनस अगेन ब्लेम, बेनिफिट मतलब प्लस पॉइंट किसी चीज का. यहां पर नेगेटिव में आएगा, ये नेगेटिव सेंस में आएगा ओनस. अगेन चार्ज या लोड. तो ए सी डी ई का सेम मीनिंग आएगा और बी का अलग आएगा. तो इसका आंसर होगा बी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. सिक्योर इन डेंजर गार्डेड इम्यून शेल्टर. तो अगर हम देखें सिक्योर का मीनिंग अगेन सेफ. इन डेंजर डिफरेंट हो जाता है, अनसेफ. गार्डेड अगेन सेफ, इम्यून भी सेफ, शेल्टर्ड भी सेफ. तो यहां हम देखें बी का मीनिंग डिफरेंट है. आंसर इज बी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. रिडीम रिक्लेम रिस्टोर एम्बैंडन रिट्रीव. रिडीम का मतलब अगेन स्टार्ट या रिज्यूम. रिक्लेम अगेन स्टार्ट और रिज्यूम. रिस्टोर भी वही, दोबारा से रिट्रीव कर लेना. ट्री भी वही, अबैंडन का मतलब छोड़ देना, गिव अप, तो आंसर इज डी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, फ्रजाइल, हेफ्टी, स्टर्डी, विग्रस. रोबस्ट अगेन स्ट्रॉन्ग और हैवी. फ्रजाइल वीक, वल्नरेबल, हेफ्टी अगेन स्ट्रॉन्ग और हैवी, स्टर्डी भी स्ट्रॉन्ग हैवी, विग्रस भी इंटेंस या स्ट्रॉन्ग हैवी. तो आंसर इज, यहाँ पर फ्रजाइल का मीनिंग डिफरेंट है, आंसर है बी. डायरेक्शन 6 to 10, चूज द वर्ड विच इज मोस्ट सिमिलर इन मीनिंग टू द वर्ड प्रिंटेड इन बोल्ड बिलो. आपको एक क्वेश्चन में नंबर वर्ड दिया गया है, आपको उसका सिमिलर बताना है. ऑप्शंस में से कौन सा वर्ड है जो उसके मीनिंग के हिसाब से है, आपको उसका सिनोनिम बताना है. स्पाउस, स्पाउस का मीनिंग होता है अडॉप्ट, अडॉप्ट और सपोर्ट, कॉज और बिलीफ, मतलब किसी बिलीफ या कॉज को सपोर्ट करना या उसे अडॉप्ट कर लेना. एम्ब्रेस, रिजेक्ट, अपोज, एब्सोल्यूट, एंडेंजर. यहां हम देखें तो एम्ब्रेस का मीनिंग सेम आ रहा है कि आप उसे अडॉप्ट कर रहे हैं या सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं. रिजेक्ट अगेन उसको हटा देना, अपोज भी गलत है, एब्सोल्यूट एंडेंजर भी. तो आंसर इज 6, आंसर इज ए. इनसाइट, इनसाइट मतलब इनकरेज, फीलिंग. डिप्रेस, अराउज, डिसवेड, हिंडर, डेडन. इसमें आंसर डिप्रेस नहीं होगा, अराउज होगा इसका सिनोनिम. अराउज मतलब अगेन आप इंकरेज कर रहे हैं, फीलिंग अराउज का भी मतलब सेम होता है, आप एक्साइट कर रहे हैं. डिसवेड नहीं, हिंडर नहीं, डेरन नहीं. तो आंसर इज बी. बॉल्स्टर, बॉल्स्टर का मीनिंग होता है सपोर्ट और स्ट्रेंथन. सपोर्ट और स्ट्रेंथन, निग्लेक्ट, ऑब्स्ट्रक, एड, हॉल्ट, अंडरमाइन. यहां पर अगेन हम देखें सिर्फ एड का मीनिंग सेम आ रहा है, तो आंसर इज सी. टिडियस, टिडियस का मतलब एग्जॉस्टिंग, टायरिंग. ऑप्शंस देखते हैं, इवेंटफुल, फिसाइल, प्लेजेंट, एग्जॉस्टिंग, एक्साइटिंग. अगेन सीधा मीनिंग है एग्जॉस्टिंग, डी. आंसर इज डी. जर्मेन, इनअप्रोप्रिएट, इम्प्रॉपर, अनसुटेबल, इरेलीवेंट, पर्टिनेंट. जर्मेन का मीनिंग होता है अ रेलिवेंट सब्जेक्ट, रेलिवेंट. तो यहां हम देखें सब्जेक्ट, इनअप्रोप्रिएट नहीं होगा, इम्प्रॉपर भी नहीं होगा, अनसुटेबल भी नहीं. पर्टिनेंट, यस, पर्टिनेंट का मीनिंग भी रेलेवेंट होता है. तो आंसर इज ई. 11 to 15, चूज द वर्ड्स विच इज नॉट द एंटोनिम ऑफ द वर्ड गिवन इन बोल्ड इन ईच क्वेश्चन. विच इज नॉट द एंटोनिम मतलब विच इज नॉट द एंटोनिम का मतलब सिमिलर. आपको सिमिलर वर्ड चूज करना है, विच इज नॉट द एंटोनिम मतलब जो उसका ऑपोजिट नहीं है, मतलब आपको सिमिलर वर्ड चूज करना है. इनसेंस, इनसेंस का मतलब होता है मेक वेरी एंग्री, मेक वेरी एंग्री. एग्जास्परेट का मतलब होता है अगेन गुस्सा करना. इन्फ्यूरिएट का मतलब अपीस का मतलब होता है उल्टा. मतलब अच्छा फील कराना, इन्फ्यूरिएट का अगेन, ट्रैंक्विलाइज का मतलब ऑपोजिट, अगेन गुड फील कराना, इसका तो मतलब होता है ट्रैंक्विलाइज का मतलब बेहोश कर देना, तो इसका आंसर आएगा बोथ ए एंड सी, आंसर इज डी. एब्जेक्ट, एब्जेक्ट का मतलब होता है एक्सट्रीमली अनप्लेजेंट, अनप्लेजेंट. कमेंडेबल, रेच्ड, मैग्निफिशेंट, नोबल, एग्जॉल्टेड. तो यहां पर आएगा रेच्ड, क्योंकि ये सब ऑपोजिट हैं इसके मीनिंग्स, तो आंसर इज बी. रेच का मतलब ही अनप्लेजेंट होता है. डिक्लाइन, डिक्लाइन मतलब टू डिमिनिश. सक्सेस, अगेन बढ़ना या इंक्रीज होना, असेंट भी इंक्रीज होना. स्लंप टू डिमिनिश, इंप्रूवमेंट, इंक्रीज, 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 तो आंसर इज सी. लार्जेस्ट का मतलब होता है चैरिटेबल, तो अगर हम देखें एक्सेप्टिंग्स का एंटोनिम होगा कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन, चैरिटेबल, टेकिंग अगेन एंटोनिम होगा, अनकाइंडनेस भी एंटोनिम होगा और अनचैरिटेबल भी एंटोनिम होगा, तो आंसर इज बी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 15, श्रिल, श्रिल का मतलब होता है नॉइजी और टू लाउड, तो स्ट्रेट अवे इसका सेम मीनिंग आता है नॉइजी, बाकी सब एंटोनिम्स हैं, काम, माइल्ड, मॉडरेट, सॉफ्ट, आंसर इज डी. गाइस ये था हमारा डिस्कशन. हमारी एक बैंक प्राइम अड्डा 247 की सीरीज चल रही है, बैंक प्राइम 2019. इसमें आपको 800 प्लस टोटल टेस्ट मिलेंगे 999 के प्राइस पे, वैलिडिटी है 9 मंथ्स की. प्लीज अवेल कीजिए, इस पे बहुत यूजफुल है ये टेस्ट सीरीज, बिकॉज आपको SBI PO, क्लर्क, RRB और IBPS PO सब सारे जितने भी बैंकिंग एग्जाम्स हैं सबके टेस्ट सीरीज अवेलेबल होंगे, बहुत यूजफुल है. और एक टाइम की सब्सक्रिप्शन है, आपको पूरे साल के लिए सारे टेस्ट अवेलेबल होंगे जितने भी अड्डा 247 की तरफ से लॉन्च होंगे. तो ऑल द बेस्ट.
गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्वांटिटेटिव एप्टीट्यूड क्विज बेस्ड ऑन क्वांटिटी कंपैरिजन फॉर IBPS. ओके, सो टुडे इज डे 21 फॉर कर IBPS 2019 फतेह. नाउ द टॉपिक इज क्वांटिटी कंपैरिजन. इट मींस दिस क्विज इंक्लूड क्वांटिटी बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस. नाउ वी विल मूव ऑन क्वेश्चंस इन द directions from 1 to 11. Compare the values of two quantities given in the question and give answer, and in bracket it is mentioned compare only numerical values. It means we have to compare only numerical value, and the options are A, if quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2, B, if quantity 1 is less than quantity 2, C, if quantity 1 is greater than or equal to quantity 2, D, if quantity 1 is less than or equal to quantity 2, and E, if quantity 1 is equal to quantity 2 or no relation can be established. Okay, so in the first question quantity 1 is maximum aggregate marks that a student can get. In an examination it is required to get 65% of the aggregate marks to pass. A student gets 684 marks and is declared failed by 8% marks. Okay, so quantity 1 is maximum aggregate marks that a student can get. So let let quantity one is let maximum aggregate marks100x. Okay, so 65x plus, or we can say 65x is equal to 684 plus 8x. Okay, minimum marks to pass is 65%, and the student get 684 marks and failed by 8%. So this this will be this. Now from here 65 minus 8 will be 57x 684. So from here value of x will be 684 upon 57. Here 3 will be common, so this is 19, this is 2 and 2 8. Okay, so this will be again, this will be 1 and 2, that is 12. So value of x is 12. So maximum aggregate marks, or we can say quantity 1 is 1200. Okay, and next question, quantity 2, number of different ways in which the letters of the word virtual will be arranged such that all vowels come together. So here quantity 2 is virtual in which these are the three vowels. Okay, so these vowels should come together. It means we will assume these three vowels as a single unit. So we will assume these three vowels as a single unit. Now remaining letters are V R D and L, that is four letters are remaining. So total letters in this case will be 415. Okay, so the required number of ways will be required ways (5), and these three vowels can also be arranged in 3 factorial ways. Okay, so this will be factorial 5 into factorial 3. So value of factorial 5 is 120 and value of factorial 3 is 6. So this is 12 into 6 720. Okay, so quantity 2 is 720 and quantity 1 is 1200. Clearly we can see quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2. Okay, so the right option for this question will be A, that is quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2. Next question, question number 2. In the second question, quantity 1 is number of balls made after casting. A solid metallic cylinder having 6 cm radius and 24 cm height is melted and recast into small spherical balls having 6 cm diameter. So radius of small balls is 6/2, that is 3 cm. Okay, volume in both cases will be same. So let, or we can say number of small balls, number of small balls will be volume of cylinder, that is pi r square h. So pi r means radius of cylinder, so this is 6, so 36, and h means height of cylinder, that is 24, and divided by volume of small spherical ball. So small spherical ball, so volume of ball will be 4/3, pi r cube. So this is 4 by 3 pi r means radius by small ball, that is 3. So cube of 3 will be 27. From here pi pi cancel, this is 9, this is 4 and this is 4. So this is 24. So number of small balls are 24. This is the quantity 1, and quantity 2 is number of days taken by A to complete the same work alone. A and B can complete a work in 12 days together. B and C can complete the same work in 15 days together, and A and C can complete the that work in 20 days together. So A plus B 12 days, B plus C 15 days, and A plus C 20 days. Okay, so total work will be LCM of these three, so this will be 60. So efficiency of A plus B will be 5, efficiency of B plus C will be 4, and efficiency of A plus C will be and C will be 3. So from here efficiency of A, B and C together will be 594 and 312 by 2, that is 6. Okay, so time taken by A, B and C together will be time, or we can say they will complete the total work in 60 by 6, that is 10 days. Okay, so from here A will complete the whole work alone. Time taken by A, time by A will be 10 into B and C 15 divided by 15 minus 10, that is 150 divided by 5, this is 30. Okay, so A will complete the whole work in 30 days alone. This is the quantity 2, and quantity 1 was 24. So clearly we can see quantity 2 is greater than quantity 1, and if we observe the options, B will be the right option. For this question, B will be the right option. Okay, now we'll move on next question. Question number 3. In the third question, quantity 2 is cost price to the manufacturer. A manufacturer sells a pair of glasses to a wholesale dealer at a profit of 17%. The wholesaler sells the same to a retailer at a profit of 25%. The retailer in turn sells them to a customer for rupees 32.76 rupees, thereby earning a profit of 40%. Okay, so cost price to retailer, quantity 2, cost price to manufacturer, this will be profit of manufacturer is 17%, so 100 upon 17 into cost price to wholesaler, making a profit of 25%, so this will be 100 upon 125, and wholesaler sells this to a retailer and retailer sells this to a customer, earning a profit of 40%. So this will be equal to 100 upon 140 into 32.76. Okay, this will be the cost price to manufacturer. Now if we solve this, this will be equal to 16. अगर हम इसको सॉल्व करेंगे तो 16 के इक्वल आएगा. दिस इज द क्वांटिटी वन, सॉरी क्वांटिटी टू, एंड क्वांटिटी वन इज एरिया ऑफ द हॉल इफ द मटेरियल कास्ट ऑफ फ्लोरिंग पर मीटर स्क्वायर इज 250 रुपीज़, वाइल लेबर कास्ट ऑफ फ्लोरिंग द हॉल इज रुपीज़ 35,350, एंड द टोटल कास्ट ऑफ फ्लोरिंग द हॉल इज रुपीज़ 14,500. सो एरिया ऑफ हॉल इज आस्क्ड, सो दिस विल बी लेट एरिया इज एरिया ऑफ हॉल इज ए मिस्टर ए मीटर स्क्वायर. सो दिस विल बी ए इंटू 250 प्लस लेबर कास्ट 3500. दिस विल बी इक्वल टू टोटल कास्ट 14,500. फ्रॉम ईयर ए विल बी 14,500 माइनस 3500,000011, दैट इज 11,000 डिवाइडेड बाई 250. ओके सो दिस विल बी 5,220. सो दिस इज 4 and 4, दैट इज 44 स्क्वायर मीटर. सो एरिया इज 44 स्क्वायर मीटर. दिस इज अ क्वांटिटी वन. सो क्वांटिटी वन इज 44 एंड क्वांटिटी टू इज 12. सो क्लियरली वी कैन सी हियर क्वांटिटी वन इज ग्रेटर देन क्वांटिटी टू, एंड ए विल बी द राइट ऑप्शन फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर्थ. इन द फोर्थ क्वेश्चन क्वांटिटी वन इज परसेंटेज ऑफ मिल्क इन फाइनल मिक्सचर. इन अ 90 liter मिक्सचर ऑफ मिल्क एंड वाटर परसेंटेज ऑफ वाटर इज ओनली 30%. द मिल्क मैन गेव 18 liters ऑफ दिस मिक्सचर टू अ कस्टमर एंड देन एडेड 18 liter ऑफ वाटर टू द रिमेनिंग मिक्सचर. ओके सो परसेंटेज ऑफ मिल्क इन फाइनल मिक्सचर. सो इनिशियली इनिशियल मिल्क, इनिशियल केस 30% मिल्क, सॉरी 30% वाटर एंड 70% मिल्क. इट मीन्स दिस इम्प्लाय वाटर इज 30% ऑफ 90, दैट इज 27, एंड 70% ऑफ 90 63. ओके दिस इज द वाटर एंड मिल्क. नाउ द मिल्कमैन गेव 18 liter ऑफ दिस मिक्सचर टू अ कस्टमर. सो एंड देन एडेड 8 liters ऑफ वाटर टू द रिमेनिंग मिक्सचर. सो फाइनल परसेंटेज ऑफ मिल्क इन फाइनल मिक्सचर, परसेंटेज ऑफ मिल्क इन फाइनल मिक्सचर, दिस विल बी रिमेनिंग मिल्क विल बी 63 माइनस 70% ऑफ 18. सो 70/100 इंटू 18, दिस इज द रिमेनिंग मिल्क इन द कंटेनर. ओके एंड टोटल मिल्क विल बी अगेन 90 इंटू 100 इंटू 100, so from here we will calculate the value. This will be 63,000 so this will be 63 minus 7 into 18 divided by 5/9, and this will be into 10, so this is 5 and 2 10, so this will be 63 minus 18 into 7 126 divided by 5, this is 126 divided by 5 will be 2 and 5.2, so 25.2, so this will be 25.2 divided by 9 into 10. If you solve this, this will be equal to 56%. Okay, this is the quantity 1, and quantity 2 is the percentage of acid in the original mixture. When 1 liter of water is added to a mixture of acid and water, the new mixture contains 20% acid. When 1 liter of acid is added to the new mixture, then the resulting mixture contains 100/3% acid. Okay, so quantity 2 is here. Let original mixture was x liter. So initially 1 liter water is added to mixture and acid, new mixture contain 20%, so quantity of acid, or we can say acid, initially acid will be 20%, that is 20/100 of total mixture. 1 liter water is also added, so x plus 1, this will be x plus 1/5. Okay, again, when 1 liter of acid is added to the new mixture, then the resulting mixture contains 100/3% acid. So new quantity of acid will be 100/3% can be written as 1/3. So this is 1/3 of x plus 2. Okay, so this quantity of acid is greater than this quantity of acid, or we can say in new mixture acid is 1 liter more than that in original mixture. So this will be x plus 2/3 minus x plus 1/5, this is equal to 1. From here this is 5x plus 10, this is minus 3x minus 3, equals to 15. From here value of x will be 2x, this is 8, so value of x will be 4 liters. So percentage of acid in original mixture will be x plus 1/5, that is initially acid was x plus 1/5, that is 6/5. So 6/5, this is the initial quantity of acid. So 6/5 × 4 × 100, so this will be this is 20, and divide 100/20 will be 5 × 6 = 30%. So initially acid was 30%, or we can say here, this is 4 plus 1, that is 5, so 5/5 will be 1. So initially acid was 1 liter, sorry by mistake, this was 6 by 5. So this will be 4 plus 1, this is divided by 5 and divided by 5 × 100, this is the original percentage of acid. So this will be 1/5 × 100, that is 1/5 divided by 4, so this is 25%. Okay, this is the original percentage of acid, this is the quantity 2, and quantity 1 was 56%, so quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2. Okay, so here A will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 5th. In the 5th question, the first quantity is number of different ways in which the letters of the word total can be arranged. So quantity 1 is, there are total 5 letters in which T is 2 times, or we can say T is repeated. So total ways will be quantity 1 factorial 5 divided by 2 factorial, that is 60. And the second quantity is perimeter of circle is, the area of circle is 616 square centimeter. So perimeter will be, or we can say quantity 2 will be 2 pi r, and r will be, or r will be 616, or we can say area is pi r square is equal to 616. So pi means 22 by 7, r square 616. So here this is 2, this is 5 6, so this is 28. So r square will be 7 into 28, so value of r will be 2 into 7, that is 14 centimeter. Okay, so the perimeter will be 22 by 7 into 14, so this is 2. So 2 into 22 into 2, this will be 88 centimeter. This is the required perimeter. So quantity 2 is 88 and quantity 1 is 60. So quantity 2 is greater than quantity 1, and B will be the right option for this question. Okay. Okay. Second question. Next question. Question number 6. In the 6th question, the quantity 2 is rate of interest per annum. If the amount is 2.25 times of the sum after 2 years at compound interest compounded annually. So quantity 1 is, this is 2.25, this is equal to 1 plus r upon 100 ka square, or we can say this will be 1.5, 1 plus r by 100. So r by 100 will be 0.5, so value of r is 50%. Okay, and the second, this is the quantity 1, and the second this is quantity 2, and the first quantity is speed of the train. A train passes a 50 meter long platform in 14 seconds and a man standing on the platform in 10 seconds. So here let speed is v meter per second. So length of train, this will be v into 10, that is 10 v. So this train crosses a platform, 50 meter long platform in 14 second. So according to question, 50 plus 10 v, this will be equal to 14 into v. Okay, so this will be 4 v is equal to 50, that is v is equal to 12.5 meter per second. This is the speed of the train, and this is the second first quantity. So quantity 1 was 50% and quantity 2 was 50%, and quantity 1 is 12.5 meter per second. Okay, so here we can see quantity 2 is greater than quantity 1. Okay, quantity 2 is greater than quantity 1, so B will be the right option for this question. Okay, next question, question number 7th. In the 7th question, the quantity 1 is, quantity 1, difference between B's share and C's share in the profit. A and B started a business with the investment in the ratio of 5:3 respectively. After 6 months from the start of the business, C joined them, and the respective ratio between the investment of B and C was 2:3. The annual profit earned by them was 1,2,300 rupees. So first investment ratio A, B and C, quantity 1, this will be ratio of A and B's investment was 5:3, and ratio of B and C investment was 2:3. So this will be 10 and this is 3 into 2, that is 6, and 3 into 3, that is 9. This is the investment ratio of A, B and C together. Okay, so according to question, profit ratio will be profit ratio, the 10, each share was for the whole year, that is 10 into 12, and this is 6 into 12, and C was 9 into 6, because investment of C was after 6 months. Okay, so this will be 20, this is 12, and this is 9. Okay, this is the investment profit ratio. So required difference will be difference of B and C share. So 12 minus 9, that is 3, divided by sum of ratios 20 and 21, 41, and this is 1 2 3 double 0. If we solve this, this will be, this is 3 double 0, that is 900. Okay, 900 rupees, this is the required difference. And the quantity 2 is the principal amount difference between the simple interest on a certain amount at the rate of 10% per annum for 2 years and the compound interest, which is compounded every 6 months at the same rate, is 124.05 rupees. So difference is given, simple interest and compound interest is 124.05 rupees. So let in quantity 2, let sum is P. Okay, so simple interest for 2 years, SI for 2 years will be 2PR, R is 10%, that is 20P upon 100, or we can say P by 5. And the compound interest for 2 years will be P, and the rate is compounded every 6 months, so P 1 plus R will be half, that is 5 divided by 100, and time will be 2 times of original time, that is 4 minus 1. Okay, so this will be 20, and this is 21 to the 21 by 20 to the power 4 minus 1. So here this will be 21 by 20 to the power 4, this will be equal to 441 into 441 divided by 400 into 400. So if we solve this, so this will be 194481 upon 4 into 4 16, 4 times 0 minus 1 into P. This is the compound interest. Now difference is 194481 divided by 16, 4 times 0 minus 1 minus 1 by 5 into P, and this is equal to 124.05. from here this is 194481 upon 16, 4 times 0 minus 6 by 5 into P, this is equal to 124.05. from here if you solve this, this will be P is equal to 124 0.05 divided by 100 into 164 times 0 divided by 2481. This will be equal to rupees 8000. Okay, so the second quantity is in this question. In the question was 7, the second quantity is 8000 and the first quantity was 900. This is the first quantity and the second quantity is 8000 rupees. Okay, so clearly we can see here quantity 2 is greater than quantity 1. Okay, and the right option for this question will be B. Okay, next question, question number 8. In the 8th question, quantity 1 is quantity 1, number of days in which work will be completed. 20 men can complete a piece of work in 15 days. One man start the work and after every day one more man joins the work and this continues till the work is completed. So quantity 1, 1 day work of one man. One day work of one man is 1 upon 20 into 15. This is the first day work of one man. This will be 1 by 300. Okay. So let after n days work is completed. After n days work is completed, so this will be after second at second day one more man joins and so on, one man increases, so this will be 1 by 300 plus 2 by 300 plus 3 by 300 plus --. After n days n man joins, so n by 300. This is equal to 1. So here 1 by 300 will be common and this is a sum of n natural numbers. So this is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus --, plus n is equal to 1. So this is n plus 1 divided by 2. This is equal to 300. So from here n square plus n minus 600 equals to 0. So from here this will be n square plus 25n minus 24n minus 600 is equal to 0. So value of n will be 24. Okay, so after 24 days the work will be completed. This is the quantity 1, 24. And similarly second quantity, percentage profit earned by the shopkeeper. A shopkeeper bought 150 brushes at the rate of rupees 250 per brush. He spent rupees 2500 on transportation and packing. The marked price of brush is 320 rupees per brush and the shopkeeper gives a discount of 5% on the marked price. So total selling price will be, or we can say total cash price is 150 into 250 plus 2500. Okay, this is 150 into 250 will be 37500 plus 2500. This will be 40000. Okay, and total selling price 150 into 320 divided 320 into 95 divided by 100. Okay, this will be total selling price, and if we solve this, this will be equal to 45600. Okay, so the required percentage profit will be earned by shopkeeper will be 45600 minus 40000 divided by 40,000 into 100. This will be 5600 into 100 divided by 4 into 4 times 0. So 4 times 0 will be cancelled. 56 upon 4, that is 14%. Okay, so 14% will be the required profit percentage. This is quantity 2, and the quantity 1 was quantity 1 24. So here we can see quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2. Okay, so the right option for this question will be A will be the right option, that is quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2. Now we will move on next question, question number 9th. In the 9th question, quantity 2 is product as smallest and second highest number if the average of 5 consecutive odd numbers is 35. So 5 consecutive odd number, so this is 35. So in this the consecutive odd numbers will be 33 and 31. So here this will be 37 and 39. Okay, these are the consecutive odd numbers. Okay, so product of smallest and second highest, so this is smallest and this is second highest. So quantity 1 is 31 into 37, so this will be 37, 31, 37, this is 3 into 7, 21, 3 into 3, 9, and 2, 1, 11. So this is 7, 4, 1, 1. So 1, 4, 1, 4, 7, this is quantity 1. And quantity 2 is simple interest on the sum on the same sum for 4 years at the same rate of interest. The compound interest on a certain amount for 2 years at the rate of 10% per annum is rupees this. So P is, let sum is P. So this will be 840 plus P. This will be equal to P 1 plus 10 by 100 to the power 2. So this is 840 plus P, and this is 121 upon 100 P. Okay, so this will be 21 P. This will be equal to 840 into 100. From here P will be 4000 4 3 times 0. This is the sum. So quantity 1 quantity 2 is simple interest, so this will be 4000 into 10 into 4 divided by 100. So this is 2 times 0. This is the 1600 rupees is the simple interest on the sum. Okay, this is quantity 1, and quantity 2 was, sorry, this is quantity 2 and this is quantity 1. So quantity 2, quantity 1 is 1600 and quantity 2 is 1147. So here quantity 1 is greater than quantity 2, and right option is A. Okay, next question, question number 10th. In the 10th question, quantity 1 is loss percentage if the cost price of 18 article is same as that of selling price of 20 article. So here selling price will be selling price of one article will be, or we can say directly loss percentage, So here directly we can say lot percentage 20 minus 18 divided by 20 into 100, that is 10%. Okay, and the second quantity is 10. So here quantity 1 is equal to quantity 2. So this is option E. So E will be the right option for this question. Okay, next question, question number 11th. In the 11th question, the quantity 1 is, in how many different ways the letter of the word camel can be arranged if all vowels come together? So here in camel, this is quantity 1. In camel, total vowels are 2, A, N, E. Okay, so the required ways will be remaining letters are C, C, M, L, that is 3, and 3, 1, 4. So this is factorial 4 into 2 factorial, that is 48. Okay, this is quantity 1. And quantity 2, here x square is equal to 2304. So from here value of x will be plus minus 48. So here quantity 1 is greater than or equal to quantity 2. Okay, so quantity 1 is greater than or equal to quantity 2 in which option? Option C. Okay, so C will be the right option. Okay, next question. In the next section, the directions from 12 to 15 is given as, what should come in place of question mark in the following number series problem? So question number 12 is, the terms are 170, 120, 50, 24, 10 and question mark. So here 170 can be written as 169 plus 1, that is 13 square plus 1. 120 can be written as 121 minus 1, that is 11 square minus 1. Similarly, 50 can be written as 49 plus 1, and this is equal to 7 square plus 1. And 25 minus 1, that is 5 square minus 1. So 10 is 9 plus 1, that is 3 square plus 1. So question mark will be, this is 13, 11, 7, 5, 3, that is 1 square minus 1. This is 0. So C will be the right option. Sorry. These are the square of prime numbers 13, 11, 7, 5, 3. Here, if there would 9, then this would be square of odd numbers. So this is the square of prime numbers. So the next term will be question mark 2 square minus 1, that is 3. So right option will be D, 3. Okay. Next question, question number 13th. In the 13th question, the terms are 829, 918, 839, 908, 849 and question mark. So this is 829, 918, 839, 908, 849 and question mark. So here first increases, then decreases, again increases, then decreases. So this is increasing decreasing series. So here 918 minus 829, this is 9, and this is 10 minus 2, that is 8. Okay, so this is minus, sorry, plus 8, 9. And in the second two terms, 918 minus 839, so this is 9. And 10 minus 3, that is 7. So this is minus 7, 9. So this is plus 6, 9. This is minus 5, 9, 908, 59, that is 9, and this is 4 and 8. Okay, so the next term should be plus 4, 9. So value of question mark will be 849 + 49, that is 898. Okay, so this is the required answer, and B will be the right option. The missing term is B, that is 898. Okay, next question, question number 14th. In the 14th question, the terms are 77, 81, 95, 125, 177 and question mark. So here 77, 81, 95, 125, 177 and question mark. So here first we check addition or differences of terms. So here this is greater than plus 4, this is 14 + 14, and this is 30 + 30, this is plus 32, and this is plus 52, because 25 and 50 will be 77. Again this is plus 10, this is plus 16, and this is plus 22. So here this is 6, here plus this is 6, so next should be plus 6, so this should be 22 plus 6, that is 28. So this will be 0 and 8, that is plus 80. So value of question mark will be 177 plus 80, that is 257. Okay, so this will be the right answer, 257. And if you look at option C, will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 15th. In the 15th question, the terms are 2, 4, 12, 48, 240 and question mark. So here 2 into 2, that is 4, and 4 into 3, that is 12, 12 into 4, that is 48, and 48 into 5, this is 240. So value of question mark will be 240 into 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so this is 1440. Okay, so this is the required answer, and if you observe the options, E will be the right option. Okay friends, so this is the end of this quantitative aptitude quiz based on quantitative comparison. I hope aap log bahut pasand aaya hoga. Thank you so much for listening to me, and best of luck for your exams.